Saban removed the Power Rangers short action film that was released a few days ago. That is, the creators of the Power Rangers were jealous, or they were mad, or scared, or whatever the reason was, they forced the short film, live action, rated R short film, to be removed from Vimeo and from YouTube. Now, you guys know that that was launched a few days ago, and on YouTube, it had over 8 million views. All the media was talking about it, everybody was talking about it on Facebook. It was definitely doing good for the franchise. People were talking about Power Rangers again. I don't understand why they will force Joseph, the director, to remove that from Vimeo and from YouTube. So there is nowhere you can find the full 14-minute live-action short film. That sucks. It really does. Now, the thing is, here's my theory. I really think that they feared that this short film was better than any live-action movie that the company will be making in the future. So they were scared that, okay, if we don't deliver the same level of awesomeness that this short film did, people aren't gonna watch our movie. Now, I beg to disagree with that concept, but I believe that's probably what it was. Because I don't think this company was just like, we wanna protect our property and blah, 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 blah. We wanna be bullies. I don't think it was that. I just think they were afraid of just losing some audience. But I really think this will have the opposite effect. If they would have allowed that movie to stay on, it could have reached maybe 40 million views. People will be talking about Power Rangers. Maybe when the trailer for the official Power Ranger movie comes out, people will be excited about it. Oh, you remember that short film? Well, you know what? Let's give this a shot. Even if the movie doesn't look good, people will want to watch it because they want to compare it to the live action movie. And I just don't understand why they would just force that to be taken out. It just really sucks. Because the director, Joseph, he paid for everything himself. He filmed this over 9 months. He casted everybody. Like, everything, it was done for the love of it. And, of course, to help his own career, because he does do music videos and things like that. Now, I don't think this is going to hurt him, even though he is in some trouble with Saban. But in terms of finding a job in the future with other companies or being hired for gigs, it shouldn't hurt him, because everybody's talking about him now. Everybody's talking about the whole situation. And the fact that a company removed that video does not change the fact that this guy is an artist. He is a master at what he does. And when you're hiring somebody, you want their talent. Even if somebody else didn't, like a different company, didn't want their talent to be open to the world, well, somebody else is gonna want that talent anyway. So I don't think it's gonna hurt him in the long run, but it definitely does suck that he worked so hard to make that short action film that was so epic, so badass, and now it is removed, nowhere to be found on YouTube. Thank you for watching. Let me know what you thought about this. Do you think Saban did the right thing, or do you think this is gonna hurt Saban in the future or in the long run? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure you give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more news and more reactions. Thank you for watching. Peace. It's Morphin time. Ooh! Yo! Damn! Go.